Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us for our virtual story time today. My name is Mrs. Amy, and I'm the Youth Services Coordinator here at the Mercer County Library in Salina. And with me, I have
Bink, Amy's helper.
All right, we're going to get started, and we're going to do some story time with you today. So first off, we're going to start with, hello, how are you? Shake our sillies out. So I need everybody to stand up.
Got a silly in your arm, shake it up. And then we're gonna do our legs and our whole body.
Gotta shake my sillies out. Shake my sillies out. Shake my sillies out. Wiggle my waggles out.
Ready, let's clap, can we clap?
Clap my crazies out. Clap. My crazies out, clap, clap, clap my crazies out, and wiggle my waggles away. I gotta
jump
my jiggles out, and wiggle my waggles away. I gotta yarn my sleepies out, yarn my sleepies out. I gotta shake my sillies out.
Shake
my sillies out. And wiggle my waggles out.
Shake your elbows.
And wiggle my waggles away.
Good job. All right, now we're gonna do some nursery rhymes. All right. Does anybody know who this guy is?
He's a pickle.
He's a pickle?
Yeah.
Do you think he's a pickle? Does he really look like a pickle to you? Miss Bing, you're silly. He is an egg, right? Humpty Dumpty is an egg. Yes. All right. Mrs. Amy likes to clap our hands when we do our nursery rhymes or tap your knees. So for this one, we're going to clap our hands. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again.
Good job.
Have you ever tried to put an egg back together? You have? When you crack it open, what do you use? How would you put it back together? What would you use, Mrs. Bank?
Maybe tape.
Some tape? That's a great idea. Yes.
How about glue?
Glue, maybe even glue would work. All right, our next one is little boy. What color is our little boy wearing? Blue. How many of you are wearing blue today? Raise your hand if you're wearing blue. Yes, all right, this one we're gonna tap our knees with. Are you ready? Little boy blue, come blow your horn. The sheep's in the meadow and the cow's in the corn. Where's the little boy who looks after our sheep? He's under the haystack, fast asleep.
Wake up!
We don't have time to take a nap today. Maybe later.
Okay, that sounds good.
All right, let's see who's next. Hey, diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle. All right, we're gonna clap our hands for this one. Hey, diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle. The cow jumped over the moon. The little dog laughed to see such fun, and the dish ran away with the spoon. your dish and spoon run away today? It did. Where did it run to?
The sink.
It ran to the sink?
Yeah.
Awesome. The sink. That's the best place for it. And I bet it took a bubble bath.
Oh, I bet it did too. Funny.
Yes.
Fun in there.
All right. Who's next? Old Mother Hubbard. Old Mother Hubbard went to the cupboard to get her poor dog a bone. But when she got there, the cupboard was bare. And so the poor dog had none. Ooh, he's such a sad puppy.
Oh, I don't think so. Look.
Whose food is he eating?
Kitty's.
He's eating the kitty's food. Would you like to eat the cat's food if you got hungry?
No.
No way. What do you like to eat when you get hungry? Pizza? Oh, I like pizza and mac and cheese. That sounds really good. There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. Do you live in a shoe? Do you live in a shoe?
Yeah, in a shoe.
You do? Oh, Pete, you.
I don't live in a shoe, Miss.
No. There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. She had so many children, she didn't know what to do. She gave them some broth. Can you drink your broth? Along with some bread. Can you eat your bread? She hugged them all soundly, then sent them to bed. Right to bed. When mom and dad or grandma or grandpa or your babysitter say go to bed, do you go to bed?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
You guys are such good listeners.
Yes.
All right. Oh, this is my favorite song, Miss Pink. Mary had a little wombat. Little wombat. What? It's my favorite song.
Does that look like a wombat?
No, that does not look like a wombat.
Looks like
what
a
is that?
Lamb to me.
A lamb. All right. How many of you think it's a lamb? Raise your hand. Do you think it's a lamb? I think so. All right, we're going to sing this one together. Are you ready? Mary had a little lamb, Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go.
Good job.
It's counting. How many of you guys know how to count? Do you know how to count,
yeah.
Miss Pink? Let's count. Ready? One, three.
Two.
One, two.
Three, four, five.
Good job. Are you ready to do it with me? One, two, three, four, five. Once I caught a fish alive. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then I let him go again. Why did you let him go? Because he bit my finger so. Which finger did he bite?
This little one on the right.
Did you need a band-aid or are you guys tough? You guys are tough. I think they're tough. Do you think they are?
I think they're tough.
Yeah. Yes. The itsy bitsy spider. Are you ready? The itsy bitsy spider went up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the itsy bitsy spider went up the spout again.
Good job.
I have a couple other spiders. All right, our next spider is either a great big spider, he's kind of scary, or a teeny tiny spider. All right, which one do you want to do next? Do you want to do the great big one? Do you want to do the great big one, Miss Pink? All right, ready? We have two great big voices. Here we go. The great big spider went up the water spout. Big rain Down came the rain and washed the spider out big sight. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the great big spider went up the spout again. Good job. All right, now we have our teeny tiny spider.
He's so teeny tiny. That's
been hard to do.
Teeny tiny voices. Are you ready? The teeny tiny spider went up the water spout.
Little rain.
Down came the rain and washed the spider out.
Little sun.
Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the teeny tiny spider went up the spout again. Good job.
All right, let's do one more nursery rhyme. And this is Twinkle Twinkle. Can you get your fingers out like this? And we're going to twinkle them like stars. Can you hold them up high? Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high. Like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Good job. All right, we have a finger play to do with you. This is five little pumpkins sitting on a gate.
So the first thing you have to do is get your gate out and put five pumpkins on top. You ready? Here we go. Here's mine.
Five little pumpkins sitting on a gate. The first one said, oh my, it's getting late. The second one said, there are bats in the air. The third one said, but we don't care. The fourth one said, let's run and run and run. The fifth one said, are you ready for some fun? Then ooh, went the wind and out went the lights and the five little pumpkins rolled out of sight.
Good job.
Okay. All right, are you ready for this next part?
I'm ready.
All right.
Story.
Our next part is our story, and we're going to reenact our story. All right. So our story is called The Little Old Lady Who Was Not Afraid of Anything.
Here comes our little old lady.
So The Little Old Lady Who Was Not Afraid of Anything by Linda Williams.
Once upon a time, there was a little old lady who was not afraid of anything.
One windy afternoon, the little old lady left her cottage and went for a walk in the forest to collect herbs and spices, nuts and seeds. She walked so long and so far that it started to get dark. There was only a sliver of moon shining through the night. The little old lady started to walk home. Suddenly, she stopped. Right in the middle of the path were two big shoes. And the shoes went clomp, clomp.
Oh no! Get out of my way, you two big shoes! I'm not afraid of you, said the little old lady. On she walked down the path, but behind her she could hear the two shoes go clomp, clomp.
Uh-oh. Does she look afraid?
No.
A little farther on, the little old lady stumbled onto a pair of pants. And the pants went wiggle, wiggle.
Wiggle, wiggle.
Get out of my way, you two pair of pants. I'm not afraid of you, said the little old lady, and she walked on. But behind her, she could hear two shoes go clomp, clomp, and one pair of pants go wiggle, wiggle. Farther still, the little old lady bumped into a shirt, and the shirt went shake, shake. Get out of my way, you silly shirt. I'm not afraid of you, said the little old lady, and on she walked a little bit faster. But behind her, she could hear two shoes go clomp, clomp,
One pair of pants go wiggle, wiggle, and one shirt go shake, shake. A little ways on, the little old lady came upon two white gloves and a tall black hat. The gloves went clap, clap, and the hat went nod, nod. Get out of my way, you two white gloves and you tall black hat. I'm not afraid of you, she said, and on she walked a little bit faster. But behind her, she could still hear two shoes go clomp, clomp. One pair of pants go wiggle, wiggle. One shirt go shake, shake. Two gloves go clap, clap. And one hat go nod, nod. By now, the little old lady was walking at quite a fast pace. She was very near her cottage when she was startled by a very huge, very orange, very scary pumpkin Boop. Head. And the head went...
Boop!
Oh, no! This time, the little old lady did not stop to talk. She did not stop at all. She ran! But behind her, she could hear two shoes go clomp, clomp. One pair of pants go wiggle, wiggle. One shirt go shake, shake. Two gloves go clap, clap. One hat go nod, nod. And one scary pumpkin head go
boop.
Oh no, the little old lady did not look back. She ran as fast as she could and didn't stop to catch her breath until she was safe inside her cottage with her door locked. There she goes, she's getting her chair. She sat in her chair by the fire and she rocked. It was so quiet in her cottage before the knock on the door. Should she answer it? Well, she was not afraid of anything. So she went to the door. Should she answer it? But she's not afraid. What do you think she saw? Two shoes go clomp, clomp. One pair of pants go wiggle, wiggle. One shirt go shake, shake. Two gloves go clap, clap. One hat go nod, nod. And one scary pumpkin head go
boom.
I'm not afraid of you, said the little old lady bravely. What do you want anyway?
We've come to scare you.
You can't scare me, said the little old lady.
Then what's to become of us?
The pumpkin head suddenly looked unhappy.
Okay.
I have an idea, said the little old lady. She whispered into the pumpkin's ear. The pumpkin head nodded and its face seemed to brighten. The little old lady said goodnight, closed the door, and whistled her way to bed. The next morning, she woke up early. She went to her window and looked out into her garden. And what do you think she saw?
Let's look out that window.
Okay.
What do you think we saw?
Here we are.
Oh my goodness. Two shoes go clomp, clomp.
They're here.
One pair of pants go wiggle, wiggle. One shirt go shake, shake. Two gloves go clap, clap. One hat go nod, nod. One scary pumpkin head go boop. And scare all the crows away. The end.
See, so she wasn't really afraid of anything, was she?
No, there was nothing to be afraid of. All right.
So I hope you enjoyed our story time today. And we have one more song before we go, and it's going to be our goodbye song.
Bye, friends.
Yeah.